Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video, we are going to learn reactive programming, asynchronous REST API approach. And we will also see the difference between traditional REST API versus reactive programming REST API. And we'll also check the performance between both the APIs. So what is synchronous and asynchronous REST API? In asynchronous approach, the operation tasks are performed one at a time, and only one is completed, then following is unblocked. In other words, you need to wait for a task to finish to move to the next one. But if you are following asynchronous approach, in asynchronous operations, on the other hand, you can move to another task before the previous one finishes. So here no need to wait, so it can process continuously without any blockage. But in synchronous approach, it will be stuck until it will receive the response. After that, it will process the next request. So we can see synchronous and blocking, but asynchronous is non-blocking approach. Now we will create two REST API and then we will see the difference between synchronous and asynchronous. So here I will just create one package, new package for model class, that is model, and inside model package I will just create one model class, that is student, and inside student class I will just define few properties, that is private int id and second will be the student name, string name. Now I will just create setter getter for both properties. So I will go to source and click on generate getter and setters. After generating setter and getter, select all, click on generate. Now I will create constructors. So here I will go again to source and click on generate constructor using fields. So here after selecting both field, click on generate. So here we can see constructor with two parameter. Now I will just copy and also create zero parameterized constructor. Remove those field from here and also remove from here. So here we can see it is a constructor that is zero parameter. Now I will create one controller class, and inside controller class I will create the REST endpoint. So here I will create one more package, that is controller package. And inside controller I will just create the controller class. So first I will create API by using traditional way. After that I will create one more API by using reactive programming approach. So here I just need to define the annotation, that is @REST controller. And if I want to define any base path for our API, for that I will define @requestMapping at class level. And this will be the base path for all the API, that is student. And inside student class, before creating REST endpoint, I will just create one more package, that is service package. And inside service package, I will create one more class, that is service class. So inside service package, I will just create one class, that is student service. Now click on finish. So here I am not going to create any interface. So here I will just define annotation, that is @service. Now we need to import this class into our controller. So I will go to my controller and will use @autoviled annotation. And here I will use student service, will import into my controller class. And here I will create one API just by using traditional REST API way. So it will be the URL of our API. So this API will return the list of student. So here I will just return the students list. Public util.list. And here I will just call service dot get students. So now I need to create this method into our service class. And here what I will do, here we just need to check the performance of our API. So here I will type start. It will be the data type will be the long and system dot current time in milliseconds, and here I will just define the end is equal to system dot current time in milliseconds, and inside this after finishing all the process I will just print the total time taken by this API. Total time taken by API, that will be the end minus start, end minus start. So here what I will do, here I will just create one list of student, and here I am not connecting with any database, so I will return the student list that I will create here. So same list I will return. So in this list I am just adding 20 students. So with the 20 students we cannot measure the performance of both APIs. So what I will do, because if you are fetching millions of record, then we can see the difference of performance in both APIs. But if we are fetching only 20 records, so here what I will do, here I will add some break between the records. For this what I will do, first I will add 20 students, and here I will use student list that will store all the 20 students. So here new student, and here ID, and second parameter will be the student name. So here I will just pass student plus I, and here to check the performance we need to add thread dot sleep. So after adding each student into list, it will take the rest for 1 second, and after that it will add second student, so it will take minimum 20 seconds. Surround with the try catch. Now what I will do, remove it. So here I have created the REST API by using traditional way. Now I will just start the application, and we'll also print each student here. So what I will do, sysout student record. So we can also see the output on console. Now I will just run this application. So first I will refresh it. Now I will go to main class and run as Java application. So here we can see on the console application has started on port number 8080, and here it's using NetEase server, and our application has started. Now I will go to browser, and here I will just type localhost 8080 student. So here we can see on the console it is by using our traditional REST API way. Until it reach up to record number 20, we will not get any response. Once it will reach at record number 20, then only we will see the response here. So now it's 18, 19, 20. So now we can see the response. Here it's fetching 20 records, and it took time around 20 seconds. So now we will create one more API that will be by using reactive programming. So here we saw until our processing, all record processing is done, after that we got the response. But if we are using reactive programming approach, then we will get record one by one. So here we no need to wait. So now I will go to my controller, and here I will create one more rest endpoint. So first I will copy it from here and will paste to second rest endpoint. So as we know, the data types for reactive programming are flux and mono. So we will use these data types as return type in our application. So here we are returning list of students. So we will use flux as a return type here. And here we can type student list. So we need to change the method name. Get students student list. And here I will just change the URL. So here I have added the stream. So here value will be the stream. And next, so in reactive programming we need to send data as a event stream. For this we need to use produces. So if we are using produces here, then only we can send data in the form of stream. Otherwise it will work as a traditional API if we are not using event stream here. So here text event stream value. So after adding produces, now I will go to my service class and will create one more method, that is public flux student get student list. So here I will not use for each loop to add this list of student, but here I will use flux. And here I need to call the methods, that is range. So here I will define how many students I want to return. So here I have added range from 1 to 20. So after that I want to perform delay after adding one record into student list. So here I will call delay elements. And here I just define duration, and in which format, duration dot of seconds. So after each record it will also wait for 1 second. And after that I just need to print all element. So here I will call do on next, and then here I will just print the statement on console, sysout student record by stream. And here I will just print the number, that is I, and remove from here. And after that we need to convert into student object. So here what I will do, just call the map method, and here I will just call new student object. And inside student I will just pass the student ID and the name of the student. So here student plus I. So remove this return null. So here I just need to add return. So here we can see I have created two API, one by using traditional REST API approach, and the second API is by using reactive programming approach. Now I will stop the server and run the application again. But we also need to check the performance. So here I will just copy these lines of code, that is start time in milliseconds and also need to add end time in milliseconds. So what I will do, I will just remove the return from here and just add one return type over here, that is student list. And here I will just call return student list from here, and we'll copy these lines and we'll add it here. So now I will run this application. I have already stopped the server. Now just run. So here we can see application has started at port number 8080. Now I will copy this URL path and we'll just click stream and hit enter. So here we can see the response in the form of data streams. So one record is coming after one, another, third, fourth, fifth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth. So one by one each record is getting, so it's not waiting or not stucking anywhere, it's getting record one by one in the form of streams. So here we can see multiple thread was executed simultaneously, so the total time taken by API was also printed before complete the processing. But here we can see the difference between both APIs. One is synchronous and second is asynchronous. So here if I will hit this API, that is by using our traditional approach. So here I will copy this URL and remove this tab and we'll hit this rest endpoint. And in our API, it is taking too much time to fetch all the records from database. Then it will stuck in waiting state until we will get all the records. So if in background processing is here, we can see records in processing. So we will not get the response until it will get all the records from database. When it will get all 20 records from database, then only we can see the response on browser. So after getting 20, it will return only response. But if we are using second approach, that is by using reactive programming stream API approach. In this approach, if you are getting only one record from database at a time, it will not wait for second record, it will send back to API. So here we can see in background, we can see the processing of records, but it's also returning to API one by one. It's not waiting for all records to get together. So here we can see how synchronous and asynchronous API work. So this is the main difference between synchronous and asynchronous API. Okay, thanks for watching this video.